Hey everybody, I'm Yvonne Williams with Back to Earth Creations, and in this video, I want to show y'all how to weave this European 6-in-1 bracelet. Now this is the project for September, what month is it? September's Craft Along Kit over on my Patreon, but there's no reason why you wouldn't be able to use your own rings or purchase some down in the video description and weave along with us. So let's go ahead and get started. So for those of y'all who get my monthly craft along kits, yours for September should be arriving any day now, but if you aren't part of my craft along club, you can still follow along with today's project. But I'm going to do the unboxing of this. Is our $20 chainmail kit for September. It's going to have a thank you note. Here we have our 18 gauge 1/4 inch bright aluminum. Here we have 4 cabochons, some of which glow in the dark and fluorescent or black light, which is pretty cool. We have a little earring kit, 2 clasps that I forgot to put in the baggie, along with a little ring for attaching the clasps, as well as one of the crystals. This one's actually quite small. Most of them should be bigger than that. That Randy and I dug up at the Ron Coleman mine in Mount Ida, Arkansas. From our trip with our niece earlier in the summer of 2019. Just because I like rocks and I think you might like them too. So you can kind of set the crystal however you like. It's more of just a little fun thing. These are great for, you can just glue a bail to the back, or you can make a bezel with these rings for your cabochons. Or you could use them in different projects, or give them to another crafty friend, or just whatever you want. You can make a chainmail connector of whatever weave that you like for the earrings, or just join it directly to the ear hook. Those are 301 surgical steel, so they are nickel free. But we're gonna start off by grabbing our pliers. You can use whatever kind that you like. A lot of folks will use 2 chain nose or 2 flat nose. I like to use a stepped flat nose from Rio Grande and a modified bent nose that I made my own thermoplastic handle out of. There are links to all the different tools, materials, and like basically links to everything down in the video description. And I'm just going to reach in and take out a pinch of rings, because I'm just going to show you how we're going to get started on our weave today. And this is suitable even if you're a very first time chainmailer. So we're gonna begin. Let me zoom in just a bit for you guys. Whenever you open your rings, you don't wanna open them too far. Like that would be, I mean, it's still manageable, but it's a little farther than what you need. You only need like about a 45 to 50 degree angle. And I'm right-handed, so I open it to where it's like this. But my partner Randy, he opens his rings like that. And I recommend, for at least the way that I'm teaching right now, to follow along with what we're doing if you open it up this way. And let's get 5 of them open. So there's 4, 5. And you'll basically need however many as how long you want your bracelet. But this should make us about an inch. Now to close our rings, like this should make us about an inch of the design. You can hear that little click happening. I'm adding just a little bit of inward pressure with my pliers and then wiggling our ring to get it to be just as closed can be. Now this is just butted chainmail. You could go through and use like riveting, or if you were using copper or silver, you could solder each individual ring, but for today's tutorial, we're just doing butted, getting the hang of the weave. And we're going to close 6 rings and put them on this one. You could also, and actually what we might do, is just pile them off to the side. And this is something great to do as you get down like the muscle memory for when you're watching YouTube or Netflix or something like that. Sometimes if I'm not paying as close of attention with my eyes, I like to go through and check with my finger to make sure that there's no pokey outy bits, like no snags or anything. We want as perfectly smooth of a closure on our ring as possible. Now these have already been cleaned and tumbled, but if through weaving, like if your pliers mark it up or just something. I do recommend feeding your chainmail through a rotary tumbler for about half an hour with some stainless steel shot, and there will be links to that down below as well. But and that can clean up your work a little bit more. If you're using a copper or silver or something and you want it cleaned after wearing it for a while and it's begun to tarnish, running it through the tumbler can clean it up really nicely as well. I love using sunsheen burnishing compound. It really, really gets in there, and a little goes a long way. Though I've also seen folks very successfully just use like dish soap and stuff. So use what you've got. So you can either stack them on there like how I did have them, or you can take your one ring to rule them all and put on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this weave is very similar to the European 4-in-1, but instead of having 4 rings on each closed, we have 6. So we're going to close that one and butterfly it to where we have 3 rings on one side and 3 rings on the other. Kind of spacing them out a little bit. I'm going to be focusing on 1, 2, 3, 4, those 4 rings. So I'm going to let you get a close look at how I have my rings laying. And if it's helpful to you, you can tie a string or a piece of wire or a paper clip or a safety pin or something onto this ring right there. I'm going to pick up 1 and hook through from below 1, 2, 3, 4. And so you can see that's kind of hanging weird. That's fine. Just keep moving forward, holding onto that ring we just put through. I'm going to put 2 closed on it, and then I'm going to close it. Still holding on to this ring, I'm rebringing my finger up from below and butterflying those 2 rings that we just added. Now, in a perfect world, I'd be doing this tutorial with different colored anodized aluminum or something so you can really tell the difference, but if you got our kit and are weaving alongside with us, I wanted us all to be looking at the same thing. So now we have 2 down the center. I'm going to pick up a new open one. I do recommend getting a solid hang of the European 4-in-1 first, which if I remember to, there'll be like a card or something popping up to where you can go do that video, and you can use this ring size for that as well. It just makes a very open and airy weave. So I'm just hooking 1 and 2, then to the other side, 3 and 4. And I'm going to add 2 more rings, and I'm going to close. And we can actually set this on the table for a moment, just so we can get a closer look at how that's sitting. So I'm going to take another open ring, I'm going to hook through. I put my finger on it just to hold it in place, but you can see how these rings down the center are all going in one direction, and then the rings on each other side are going in the other. That's characteristic of the European weaves. So I'm just hooking 1, 2, 3, 4. And then adding on 2 more, and then closing. And the good news is once you kind of get the hang of opening and closing rings in chainmail, that's one of the biggest obstacles. Once you have that muscle memory down, a lot of the things in chainmail are going to become a lot more accessible to you. Now let's troubleshoot a little bit. Now what if you only hook 1 ring from each side? Well, you're going to start having a European 4-in-1 patterning, and it's going to look a little too wide, and you can use that as a design element, but if that's not what you're going for, just pull back out, hook through 1, 2, and then 3, 4, and then add your 2 other rings, and you'll just kind of keep that weave going. Also, what if it ends up looking like this? Well, usually when that'll happen, you'll have your rings incorrectly butterflied for this weave, like just hooking through. So if that keeps happening, you want to make sure that one is pulled off to each side of what you're doing. Like it should be mirror imaged down the center. Also, don't forget to hook 4 instead of just 2 so we can keep the 6-in-1 going. Add your 2 more rings, Now, this weave can be accomplished with larger ring sizes, but I have a hard time getting smaller rings to, like, I don't think that this would work with an 18 gauge 3/16, because there just wouldn't be quite enough space inside each one ring to, to kind of fit everything in. So now this does also work well with an 18 gauge 5/16. 16 gauge 5/16 is still quite snug, but let me go look up what aspect ratio this is, and I'll kind of, I've got like a little chart that I can pull out for you guys. So I'll be right back with that, and we'll have woven to our full bracelet length, because we're, yeah, by the way, we're making a bracelet today. This is how the weave is looking. I've woven 35 units of one open with two closed on them, except for the first, which was the one open with the six closed. And work goes the doggy dog. The different ring sizes, like when we don't coil and cut our own rings, we really like getting them from Chainmail Joe. That's where the links are linked down in the video description. And I'm currently using 18 gauge 1/4 inch, which has an aspect ratio of 5.3. So I'd recommend a 5 or a 5.3 for other ring sizes. So, other ring sizes for this weave. So if we went down a gauge, that would be 20 gauge 3/16 would work out well for this. Though it's quite dainty. I'd do that only if I were soldering. We're using like stainless steel or something. Again, it's really tight with the 16 gauge, but if you don't want to have to do all that thinking, we can just flip it over. And the weave size, you can see European 6-in-1, he recommends a 4.5 to 7. I think on those lower ends, that would be, I mean, really snug, but I think it would also look really cool. So that's really cool. It comes in, you get a card like this whenever you order like a pound of rings. Really, really useful stuff, and very high quality rings. Honestly, it's, I can't tell the difference between his rings and ours. Whenever we coil and cut, he does a phenomenal job, top quality. But once we've gotten, and you could, if you're following along with us, just leave it at one single row wide, but I wanted to show you guys how to how to complete this into a bracelet and how to expand it to be another row wide. So if we were to complete the bracelet as it is right now, I would take two more rings, open one up, and I'm gonna hook through, just like I were continuing the weave, through 1, 2, 3, 4, and close. And then I'm gonna take another, open, 1 and 2, and that's what I'm going to hook through our clasp. So you can see how it does that. And honestly, I don't know, let's see. Ooh, my tablet's going wild over here. I bet that's our Discord channel. There is a link down in the video description, you'll notice a trend here, to our Discord channel, where y'all can hang out and post pictures and ask questions and all sorts of stuff. And usually if I'm not recording, I try to participate over there in that as well. So you can see just attaching a little bit like that. And then we would do that same thing here on the other end. Just hooking through 1, 2, 3, 4 without adding on more rings. Though you could extend this just, you know, doing like a 1-1 chain. Or you could use the little ring that comes attached with your clasp. I'm just going to open that. Put that on right there. and close it. And that's just one of many ways that you can bind off your chainmail into wearable jewelry. So now I'm going to go ahead and take that off, and we're going to start expanding out the other side to show you how we do that. Also, I really do like using magnetic clasps with chainmail jewelry. Okay, so we have our weave here.
I'm gonna take this from you.
Okay, so my partner Randy was setting up one open with, we should have one closed on each, except for the first one that's going to have three. So let's see here. So we have our first, oops, dropping it. We have a ring, one open with three closed, and we're going to come in, let me scooch that off to the side, try to not mess up all the rings, and we're going to start back right at the beginning, and I'm going to hook through one, two, and three. Doesn't matter which side, we'll just hook through them. And I'm going to close that, and I'm going to lay this on the table, and we're going to butterfly these so that, and you'll notice they kind of just almost hop right into place sometimes. I don't know if that's just lucky or what, but how they're branching off to that side there. So now we're going to take, well, we're going to throw it on the ground because, you know, that's how to make jewelry. One open with one closed on it. And following the weave, we want that same repetition. So I'm gonna hook through one and two, and then come up from below. One and two and three. So two that were already woven through, and then one new one. So this does really help, again, if you are familiar with the European foreign one. Now these, just the first couple are gonna be the hardest over here on this one. So we're gonna take another one open with one closed on it. We're gonna hook through one, two, and then come through, and I actually have an easier time from the other direction. So if you're having a heck of a time with it, just flip it around, you'll be fine. So I'm gonna hook through one, two, three, one new one, and then two that were already woven through, and then hooking through one and two. And so what's happening is we're still ending up with six rings on each one. And sometimes if the ring gets a little bent, just squeeze it with your pliers, it's fine. Or replace it, it's your own preference. So again, we're gonna hook one right there, then one, two, for a total of three. Then we're gonna come over to this one and that one, and then close. Let's do one more. Hooking through one, two, three. Sorry, my dog had hiccups. I don't know if y'all could hear that. One and two. Oh, it's okay, puppy. And close. So now we can see. Let's get that straightened out. Kind of tap it a bit, get the rings laying correctly. And now we have a double wide, two rows wide. Well, actually it's one, two, three, four, five. You know, so it's, if you count the different grain lines. We could have also gone through and woven two lengths and then just sewn them up, hooking through three on one side and three on the other with more rings. So that's an optional route to go as well. If you think you might be doing better with written out tutorials, I highly recommend mailartisans.org. They are phenomenal for written tutorials. It's like all sorts of different tutorials from different people, pictures, yeah, some CGI stuff. It's really cool. So to finish off the end now, I'm going to open up a couple. Let's pretend like we've woven all the way down. And I'm going to come in over here and I'm going to hook through one and two and three and four. Just kind of filling in the weave. So now we're the same on this side. And now I'm going to take another and hook through one and two. Now we could just do that like it was four and one, but I think it's a good idea to continue the weave. So let's hook through one, two, three, four. We already did that, didn't we? Okay. So we will just be hooking through those two. And this could either be the ring that you attach your belt, like, not your belt, your clasp to. Like, I like to use the little ring to hook through both of them. It just keeps things from getting as floppy as what they could. And then I'm going to hook through our clasp and close it. And so that's the way that our end looks, even when it's under tension. Now when it's under tension, these side rings still flop a little. If you are a wire wrapper, there's a way that you can kind of go through that. I'd use like a 16 gauge wire that you can come through and use some stepped mandrel pliers. And instead of bringing the end out to a tip, you'd have it be completely flat. And I'll do a separate tutorial about this, if y'all are interested, on how to make this style of clasp. But I'm just coming in and using the same size mandrel for all the loops. And I don't even know if this is going to be long enough, actually. Making one loop off to the side. And then coming down, building it back off in the other direction. And then coming all the way out to the end. Just to keep that spacing nice. Use your flush cutters to snip. Use your pliers to smoosh. And you could take this and hammer it out a little bit. And they do sell some clasps on the market that are already kind of set up like this. But what we would do is remove these additional rings that we've added. And if we had some smaller rings, so see how we have like a flat edge there? You could use smaller rings and attach to each point. Though actually, let's see, since we made this clasp. No, yeah, that just opens it up a bit. We could just open up the end here. Hook through that ring. And close it. We can open up that loop there. Hook that ring on. And close it. But since it's not laying on like exactly the same plane as the rings in the bracelet, it makes like for a little bit of tension. And so they don't quite lay properly. So I'd rather have used a smaller, I think, here it is. This is a little jar of 18 gauge 1/8 inch. Now these weren't included in the kit, but y'all are a crafty bunch of folks and you probably have some different materials on hand. So I wanted to explore some of those different options with you guys. So instead of just opening it and attaching it, we'll just take that. Also, just to be clear, I want you guys to know that I said folk, like F-O-L-K. It just occurred to me that that might have sounded really rude. not my intent, but you know, take it as you will. And you could do 4 loops or you could do 3 loops, just depending. Because if we had just done 3 loops, we could have attached to this ring, and that ring. But this is what's going on. Oftentimes to find something this width, I often see 4 loop bars, but that's okay. One and two. Those. And then again, to kind of see how it's going to attach, we just lay it down. And now what I think I'm going to do is I'm actually going to put both rings through this center row here. So let me bring that up. So hooked through that and then brought off to one side and then close. And you can get this ring size from Chainmail Joe as well. Though we do send it out sometimes in our craft along kits. Okay, so you can see now how that attaches. And it's not perfect. We could have attached to both maybe. I don't know, some experimentation is in order for finding your ideal way for attaching clasps. And then we would just use a ring to attach right there. So I'm going to finish up this bracelet and then I'll meet you guys here to show you how the project looks at the end. So this is how the bracelet has come out, and I devised a little bit different of a finishing end just with some wire. And so there are different options, different routes that you can take, experiment and find what you like. But I just basically made like a loop and then used my mandrel pliers to make a little, you know, ring on each side and then just wove it in like it were a continuation of the weave. And I offset it just a little bit. You can see how it's bent like that. And this way we can attach a clasp to one side and a ring, or 2 or 3 or 4, depending, you know, if you want to make it very adjustable, to the other side, and then close it. For just this bracelet, I like this side better, but if I were to do a bracelet double wide of this, or you know, any wider than this, and I would go with hand making one in this style. That way we can kind of make it however wide or wide that we need it to be. But there it is, some European 6-in-1. Hey y'all, thanks so much for hanging out with me. I really hope that this video was helpful to you. If you have any questions, comments, or ideas, please leave them down below. There's also, I think I'd mentioned, the Discord. You can post pictures of what you make or your favorite way of finishing bracelets or different things like that to our Discord. You can also tag me on Instagram. If you enjoy my free tutorials and would like to see more like them, please like, share, subscribe, check us out on Patreon. We now do a weekly weekend live stream exclusive to our patrons, and that's a dollar and up. We also do all sorts of behind the scenes content and our $10 cab boxes and craft along kits and all sorts of different things over there. If you didn't like it, it didn't get any better. Hopefully it was helpful to you. And yeah, leave comments and stuff. I don't know. It's y'all have seen YouTube videos before, you know, the end spiel, like ring my bell, all that good stuff. But I will see y'all in our next video. Also, if you have any requests, pop those down to the comments. I'd love to hear what you guys are interested in learning. But yeah, I think that's it. So thank you to everybody for watching. Thank you to all of our very generous patrons and all that stuff. But I'll see y'all in our next video. So until then, happy crafting. Bye.